Today on BRStv, we have the Radion G4. Hi, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv. This week, we're going to take a look at the latest update to the popular Radion LED light. The new G4 claims you have improved coverage and evenness of spread and blending, color options, noise reductions, and control. So we're going to take a closer look at each and see what we can find. If there's only one takeaway from this, it's that the LED manufacturers are starting to hear the reefing community, which wants more even spread from their LED lighting. When the first generation of LED lighting came out for reef tanks around a decade ago, the only real thought was, can LEDs produce enough PAR in the right spectrum to produce a thriving reef tank? Well, the maximum PAR goal was pretty easy to achieve, and most of the better LEDs out there now produce enough light even for advanced reef tanks. One could argue that that sales point's actually been detrimental to a lot of hobbyists because the lights are now so powerful that it's become difficult to know what percentage to run them at without providing too much light and bleaching a lot of corals. So the conversation has evolved over the years. As a community, we learn, identify solutions, and improve the life support systems of our reef tanks. Some of the biggest conversations in relation to LEDs these days is reducing hot spots, eliminating shadowing effects, and blending the color from the individual LEDs better. The hotspots I'm talking about are in the 700 plus range. You get 10 to 12 inches underneath the LEDs themselves, but 6 inches to the right, it's just 300 PAR, and 6 inches more, it's just 30. This is often true even at the bottom of the tank, where the lenses have focused the light to try to get the maximum PAR readings possible. More or less without a PAR meter, this is just a guessing game of where to put a coral, and it's pretty difficult in the top half of the tank, where one side of the coral could easily have double the PAR of the other side, which is going to cause it to either grow towards or away from that intensity and produce stressed, oddly shaped corals. This is where the biggest advancement for the G4 Radion comes in. They're HEI, or hemispherical edge illumination lenses. Rather than focusing the light into the strongest, most focused beam possible, these little globes are designed to spread the light out into the widest angle possible to reduce hot spots and produce a more even blanket of light for the tank. So does it work? The answer is absolutely. Not only does it spread the light out more evenly, it's also significantly increasing the overall amount of light entering the tank. We took measurements of both the G3 XR30 Pro and the G4 XR30 Pro at 36 points underwater at depths of 6, 12, and 18 inches. At 6 inches deep, you can see an immediate difference where all the G3's peak PAR in the 4 to 700 range were in a very distinct rectangular shape that matches the rectangular shape of the module. Just 6 inches outside of that rectangle, the PAR drops down to 150 or so, and less than 100 in the corners. With the G4 at 6 inches, we see almost double the PAR outside of that rectangle, and the light pattern is a much more even circular pattern. When we measure the average of all 36 data points on each, the average PAR jumps from 168 to 195, which is a pretty big improvement. At 12 inches, the difference is even more significant. Again, the G3 has a somewhat rectangular light dispersion pattern, but at this depth, it is spread out a bit more, and it's the outer ring that sees the biggest falloff. With the G4, you can see the PAR dispersion is almost completely circular at this point, and the outside edges are 50 to 100 PAR higher, and the average of all 36 data points goes from 169 with the G3 to an impressive 210 with the G4, which again not only makes the PAR spread out more evenly, but overall substantially more light. At 18 inches deep, you can see the G3 still has a significant cone shape, which is almost double in the center versus the edges. The G4, however, is basically flat. In the center 30 inches across, you can see the PAR is all around 200s and doesn't vary more than 80 points, and the average PAR goes from 167 to 214. Since a vast majority of the corals in your tank will likely be in that 12 to 18 inch deep range, I think these numbers support a drastic improvement in spread and evenness of light intensity. And because of that, I think this is probably the biggest leap forward between any generation of the Radion releases. Another improvement in relation to these HEI wide-angle lenses is an improvement in reducing shadowing effects from single sources of light like these LED pucks. Shadowing isn't generally a significant issue for most LPS or well-planned mixed tanks, but with SPS-dominated tanks where the corals are packed together tightly, or even just a handful of large specimens, I think reducing shadowing has become the number one focus. As the SPS corals grow, they can shadow each other, but they can also shadow the inner layers of the coral, which generally causes tissue recession. In the inner layers, coloration issues, and even mortality. Old school reef lights used a strong single source of light with a halide bulb, then a giant reflector to create a pretty even blanket of light, or long T5 lights with reflectors, which also coats the tank with hard to shadow light. This is obviously more of a challenge to do with compact clusters of LEDs like the ones popular in most LED modules. However, these new wide-angle HEI optics seem to have improved on that substantially, particularly when there's multiple radions on a single tank and they can assist each other from varying angles. Another thing to keep in mind on these types of tanks as well, the recommended coverage for a radion is around 24 inches, which means two on a 4-foot tank. That advice is aimed at the 80%. If you're an SPS fanatic and all the corals will be jammed together, consider spacing them every 18 or even 12 inches, and depending on your coral placement in aquascape, consider turning them so the front to back coverage is nice as well. Last bit on the HEI optics is the wide angle spread has improved color blending, which not only reduces the disco ball effect, but also helps blend the spectrums together better for the corals. In relation to that, they've also tweaked the spectrums a bit as well, with the normal radion getting a warm white channel and a change to photo red, and the pro getting a violet channel, which makes for one of the widest spectrum lights we've tested. Just for reference point, we also took readings of each individual spectrum for those of you who might be interested. Using the MK350S, the UV appears to peak around 410, the violet around 430, royal blue 445, the blue channel is around 470, cool white has a distinct peak around 450 in green, yellow, and red additions, warm white has a huge spike right around 600 in that orange spectrum where red and yellow meet, the green channel peaks at 515 and the red right at 660. Together they create one of the widest, most inclusive spectrums in adjustable aquarium lights out there. Program is all still done in the EcoSmart Live platform like previous generations, meaning you can program your light via USB on your computer with the optional purchase of the Reef Link for a wireless controller that works on most devices. Being the default leader in LED lighting for reefing, I think everyone found it fairly surprising the G4 wasn't released with a wireless option which allows you to connect directly to the light without any accessories, since most of the latest competitive products have that feature. But for now, the Reef Link is a perfectly suitable option. I'm also told it will be compatible with the WXM module from Neptune for those of you that own an Apex. EcoTech is also using a new heatsink which increases surface area and a new fan system with the G4. Net result is a fan can run a lot quieter, which for a lot of people who run these in their living spaces is important. So more or less, I think they lived up to their promise with the G4. Better spread, more even intensity, better color blending, improved spectrum, and it runs quieter. Modular LED lighting just took a pretty decent step forward. If you have any questions about the light, how to use it, or anything else related to lighting, let us know in the YouTube comments below or Facebook comments on the BRStv area of our site. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button because we release multiple reefing videos like this one every week.